Good morning, students. My name is Praveen Kumar, working as a PGT English JNV1 Malkangiri, Odisha. Today, we are going to learn a lesson called The Third Level, written by Jack Finney. It is taken from supplementary reader of class 12th, Vistas. In this lesson, I am going to discuss four parts, four things. What are they? Introduction part of the lesson, that is background of the lesson. About the author, and I'll briefly summarize the story, then I'll get into explanation of the lesson. Okay, first let us get into introduction part. Okay, introduction part. The introduction part of the lesson is Third Level by Jack Finney is about the harsh realities of war. War has irreversible consequences, thus leaving the people in a state of insecurity. It is also about modern day problems and how common man tends to escape reality by various means. In this story, a man named Charlie hallucinates and reaches the third level of the Grand Central Station, which only has two levels. Means the character Charlie is related as a common man who want to escape from the modern day problems. As part of the escaping, he get into the hallucinations and reaches a third level of Grand Central Station, which actually have only two levels. Okay, next up, the characters involved in the story. First, Charlie is a protagonist of the story. Next, Sam is psychiatrist who is a friend of Charlie. Next, Louisa, beautiful wife of Charlie. Next, we'll discuss about the author. The third level is written by Jack Finney. His name was Walter Braden Jack Finney, born on October 2nd, 1911. Before, actually his name was John Finney. He's a renamed, I mean after that he has renamed as Jack Finney. Okay, he was an American author. His best known works are science fiction stories and thriller stories. One of the best novels is The Body Snatchers, and one more is Time and Again, in which The Body Snatchers was the basis for the movie made in 1956 called Invasion of Body Snatchers. If we see the writings of Jack Finney, most of them are science fiction and thriller stories. Let us get into the third part of the discussion, that is, I'll briefly summarize the story, summary of the story. The story revolves around a 31-year-old man named Charlie who experiences something weird. One day, after work, coming from subway, means after completing his work, in order to reach the home quickly, he has chosen subway instead of going regular way of bus, but he has chosen subway today. Because of that, what happened? He reached the third level of the Grand Central Station, which doesn't actually exist. Means the Grand Central Station is having only two levels, but today he entered into a third level. He explains entire the experience with his psychiatrist friend called Sam, the second character. Charlie thought he experienced time travel and had reached somewhere in the 1890s. A time before the world saw two of its most deadliest wars. As soon as he realized what time he is in, he immediately decided to buy two tickets to Gallisburg, Illinois, present in United States of America, one for himself and another for his wife. Unfortunately, the currency used in that century was different. So, because of different century he found in that place, then he went back to home and he Next day, he withdrew all his savings and got them converted, even if it meant bearing losses also. He went looking for the third level but failed to find it. It worried his wife and the psychiatrist Sam, who told him that he is hallucinating in order to take refuge from reality and miseries of the modern world, which is full of worry. Charlie thus resorts to his stamp collection in order to distract himself, when suddenly one day he finds a letter from his friend Sam, who had gone missing recently. Sam, in that letter, wrote that he always wanted to believe in the idea of third level, and now that he is there himself, he encourages Charlie and Louisa to never stop looking for it. That means you don't stop for hallucinating. You enjoy Galesburg living over there. That was the end of the story. Okay, now get into the explanation of the lesson. Okay. The story begins with the mention of a third level at the Grand Central Station, which only has two levels in real. The protagonist, Charlie, himself is aware that even the president of New York Central know that would express that great confidence with a great confidence in that existence of only two levels, but he himself has been to third level. Considering that entire scenario, Charlie, the protagonist, had a word with his psychiatrist friend. He explained that Charlie was experiencing a waking dream with fulfillment. In other words, it is called hallucination. According to psychiatrist, Charlie was unhappy. The fact is, her wife did not like. Upon explaining further, it became clear that it is the burden of all modern problems that is pushing him to experience the apparent perception of something not present. He tends to escape the reality. Actually, he is not accepting the prevailing situations of the modern world. In that, his wife is also not liking him. He is trying to make his wife like him more and more, and he is also having so many problems. Not only he, common man is having a lot of problems in modern world. So, because of that, he tends to escape the reality. Charlie agreed with what his psychiatrist friend had to say, but he still found it a bit odd to have been to third level of Grand Central Station. Charlie begins to believe in the possibility that he has been experiencing all this to escape the harsh realities of the modern world. His friend agreed to it as well. Even his stamp collection is a sort of a habit he resorts to in order to feel protected. On the other hand, he starts thinking otherwise. His grandfather started his stamp collection, but in those days, they had not seen the consequences of war, and there was peace and harmony and security in those days. His grandfather must have not been insecure. The collection, moreover, was amazing, with the blocks of four, practically even US issue. Even President Roosevelt collected stamps in those days. Our protagonist, Charlie, starts explaining what exactly happened and began with how he chose to take the subway to his apartment instead of the usual bus after a late night shift. He did this in order to save time. He described in the story as like this. He described himself as an ordinary man of 31 years old, dressed in a tan gabardine suit and a straw hat with a fancy band. It was so ordinary that he could see other similar men at the station. he explains how he was in his normal state of mind, not wanting to escape from anywhere. All he wanted was to be with his wife Luisa at that hour. He still doesn't understand why this happened to him. See how all these experiences also, why he want to get into normal position, but he is not becoming. He is getting to the subway and he was not in a suit position, and in that hour he wanted to be with his wife Luisa. That is only the reason he want to get back to home quickly, but he has chosen a subway for that reason. But something is getting confusion. Why it is happening to me only? Charlie comes to the part of incident where he entered a Grand Central from Vanderbilt Avenue and took the stairs to the first level, where one boarded train like the 20th century. Then he went down another floor to reach the second level, from where the suburban trains leave. From there, he entered as a arched doorway and got lost. See, after all entering into that subway, something was happened. He found an arched doorway. From there, he entered. And what he found, it was nothing unusual for him. It was usually happens to him regularly. Means he's thinking about to have a pleasure to his mind. Because even he had come to that station 1,000 times, but there were occasions he bumped into new corridors and doorways. Once he entered the wrong lobby and reached Roosevelt Hotel, and another time in an office building which was 3 blocks away. These are the different hallucination experiences, says by Charlie, in the past. Now, in this situation, before entering the third level, he entered into the arched doorway, reached a wrong lobby, where he found so many innumerable people over there, different. That is the entry of his third level. He wondered that Grand Central was expanding at a very fast rate, just like a tree and with its roots. It's no big deal that they even have a secret tunnel under the city to Times Square or maybe the Central Park. He feels it might be because Grand Central is a place of exit for innumerable people. He also managed to escape reality because of the same reason, although he never shared it with his psychiatrist. The unusual corridor he had entered into began angling left and slanting downwards, which he felt odd about, but nevertheless, he kept on walking. There was no one except him, and the voice of his feet echoed. He finally heard the sound of people talking from a distance. Then he took a left and walked down the stairs again, only to reach the third level of the Grand Central. Then he entered into the Grand Central third level. He thought he had somehow made his way back to second level, but as he noticed, the room was smaller. He thought that he wanted to get back, but he found very small room. He realized that I'm not back to second level, but I entered to somewhat different room. Then he found a small room. There were few ticket windows and train gates, and the information booth in the central was wood and old looking. The man in the booth was also different, and the station was dim lit, for there were open flame gas lights. Charlie could see brass spittoons everywhere when suddenly a glimpse of light caught his eye, and he saw a man pulling his gold watch from the vest. Means the habit of the man pulling watch from the west is belongs to 19th century, that is around 1890s. He was dressed in a old fashioned style. Suddenly he noticed that everyone was dressed like the 19th century. It was basically the time before deadly wars, deadly world wars 1 and 2. So many beards and fancy mustaches all around, something that the protagonist, or Charlie, had never seen before. He even saw a very small carrier Ivy's locomotive trains, which made him sure that which time he is in. That means he thinking that he is went back to the time 1890s, that is 19th century. To validate his suspension, he went over the newspaper boy who was selling the newspaper called The World. Actually, the newspaper which was discontinued years ago. There were some headlines about the President Cleveland in that newspaper. The date on the front page was also June 11, 1894. He was now sure. He is now becoming sure that he went back to 19th century, that is 1890s. By the date June 11, 1894, he immediately went to the ticket window to confirm his imagination, to get the tickets for Galesburg, Illinois, for him and his wife. It was a wonderful town with a lot of greenery. Which town? Galesburg in Illinois of United States. He was well aware that from here one could buy tickets that would take them anywhere in the United States. He described how things were in 1894 before the two world wars took place. Evenings were twice as long as they are now, and men, women living in peace and serenity. At the clerk, he went to purchase the tickets in the ticket window. The clerk inside the ticket window calculated the fare for his ticket. He asked for two tickets, so he calculated and told. Then he looked at Charlie's fancy hat band. Charlie just had enough for one-sided journey only. He is having only one-sided journey currency only. Just as he took out money, the clerk informed that this is not the acceptable legal tender because that is 1894's time. Now he is giving modern currency. That is the problem took place. Then by any chance, if he tried to be smart, he won't be able to get away with it. He glanced at his cash drawer and realized that currency used back then was different and almost double the size. The protagonist, Charlie, found the cash inside the drawer of a ticket vendor. He found double the size the currency he is having. So he realized that something is different. Then he ran out because he did not want to go to jail. He pressurizes to get the ticket. Na, the currency is different, so ticket vendor will inform the police will take him to jail. So he don't want to get into jail. So he ran away from the ticket vendor window. Then he reaches to home. Okay, then the day goes. And next day, he reaches to the bank to exchange the currency of old notes. So the next day, he went to withdraw his entire savings and got them converted into old money by paying some amount of premium. It cost him much and even worried his psychiatrist friend, but he still went with it back then. Okay, even though he is getting into the losses, he purchased by paying some premiums. Unfortunately, what happened? But unfortunately, he could never find the way to the third level corridor again despite hard efforts. On the next day, his wife Louisa was pretty worried when she got to know about it all. After a while, he went back to finding distractions with the help of stamps. As something he has missed, the third level, on next day. So, in order to distract himself, he went back to stamp collection again. He checked his stamp collection. Somehow, Sam, the psychiatrist, disappeared out of the blue. Okay? Because of this reason, he disappeared. Charlie suspected that he had gone to Galesburg. He finds himself in the time space of 1894. One night, Charlie came across a first day cover. He found a cover inside his home at one night. It is an envelope with a stamp on it. That stamp collectors mail to themselves on the first day of its sale to make their date. They are just blank inside, are not meant to be opened. That night, he found, by surprise, one of his grandfather's old first day covers. Someone had mailed it to his father at his home at Galesburg. As he saw from the address on the envelope, the postmark showed that it had been there since July 18, 1894. The stamp had a picture of President Garfield on it. It was a 6-cent dull brown color stamp. His grandfather had put it in his stamp collection, and Charlie now discovered it, the paper inside and a letter written in it. The letter written in it, that cover, what is that? He has opened the letter. He started reading as 941 Willard Street, Galesburg, Illinois, July 18, 1894. Charlie, I got to wishing that you were right. Then I got to believing you were right. And Charlie, it's true. I found the third level. I have been here 2 weeks. And right now, down the street at the Dolly's, someone is playing a piano. And they are all out on the front porch singing, Seeing Nelly Home. And I am invited over for lemonade. Come on back, Charlie and Louisa. Keep looking till you find the third level. It's worth it. Believe me. This was written in that letter. It is like written someone to his grandfather, but it is making him to think that it is written to, it is his experience, like someone has written to him also, and come back to the Galesburg. Let's have enjoy. Let's have a full love, happy in Galesburg. That letter indicates that Sam is a psychiatrist. The story ends at a mysterious note where Charlie is wondering that Sam is a psychiatrist. And in that, he also finds some old currency, mentioning that this currency is $800, which is used for hay and feed and grain business. Means it is mentioning that the thing has happened at the time of grandfather's time. This makes him to experience the third level. With that letter, he realizes that Sam is a psychiatrist. This letter makes is the end of the story. Okay, this letter is the end of the story. Okay, all the students, hope you have understood. Okay, till the next video, keep learning, keep practicing. Okay, happy study. Thank you all of you.